Good day to all you ghouls and gals out there. I recently found out that there is a television movie from 1983 that are based on one of the cases from the controversial couple Ed and Lorraine Warren. It's actually the same case that will serve as the basis for the upcoming Conjuring 3 movie. And while Conjuring has an insanely bigger budget, this TV movie has Kevin Bacon. I am Torstein from CinemaTerror, and this is the Demon Murder Case. I want to start out by giving a quick summary of the actual case known as the Devil Made Me Do It case that this is based upon. This case is the first in the United States where the defendant claimed innocence due to being under a demonic possession during the crime. The guy in question had murdered the boss of his girlfriend after they had been out for dinner and a few too many drinks. This became a big media case at the time, and an elaborate backstory of this possession was presented to the public. It was claimed that a demonic force had first possessed the little child brother of this murderer, and even a big exorcism with the church and the assistance of the Warrens was unable to put an end to it. That demon would later transfer from the little brother of the girlfriend to the guy in question, and that's what laid the groundwork for this murder. This defense was not allowed during the trial, and he was eventually sentenced with 10 to 20 years in prison, and would serve 5 of them before being released. The demonic possession story would however not go away. It became one of the most notable cases from the Warrens, books have been written about it, The Conjuring 3, The Devil Made Me Do It will use it as its premise, although I'm sure that movie won't follow the case facts closely and likely will include some new evil characters that they can spin into more disappointing Conjuring spin-offs. And then there is this movie, the NBC TV movie The Demon Murder Case from 1983.
This entire defense will be seen by the world through the eyes of the media, excuse me.
Mr. Harris!
I tell you this is a battleground. This is not a case of murder, this is a confrontation between the devil and the human race.
Instead of trying to trick the viewers into thinking everything here were factual, the opening credits is making it clear that this is what the defense said happened, and it is not necessarily the entire truth. Way different than usual, based on a true story, that has a purpose of putting the idea in your head that this might have happened and could one day happen to you. The Demon Murder Case gets things going surprisingly quick for a TV movie, as it doesn't take long before the small child becomes possessed. Then things go crazy, with all kinds of possession stuff that they could come up with after watching The Exorcist. The child acts evil, levitates, and speaks as disrespectful as they could on a TV production. The first act moves along so quickly that I actually wanted a bit more time, both for the build-up and to give the people involved some time to breathe and show how this is affecting them. There's no time for that in this 92-minute long movie though, and it made me think that this would have improved if they had split it up into a two-part miniseries, or go in a more fictional direction and skip the whole trial part, but I guess that part was kind of the point of doing the movie in the first place. I actually enjoyed this a lot for the first half. The part with the small child being possessed was pretty cool, even if it is a softer TV version of The Exorcist. There were no money for special effects, so the filmmakers had to pull out some old school camera tricks, some that worked and some that did not. When the demon goes out of the boy and into our main guy, played by Kevin Bacon, my enthusiasm went down. I was hoping for some madness with Kevin Bacon, but he doesn't get to do that much devilish stuff. His violent act at the end is kind of anticlimactic, and I understand why they didn't use more creative freedom on it, but as a movie it would have benefited from a more exciting ending. The last 30 or so minutes just fell flat, and I easier bought the over-the-top possession stuff with the little kid than that Kevin Bacon had some demonic influence within him.
Your yellow guts stink!
No, you're the one who stinks. You're the one who stinks, man. You come out of Brian so I can fight you! You coming to me, I'll show you who stinks!
But facts and reality is not what I'm looking for when I'm watching movies like this. Regardless of what you believe about Ed and Lorraine Warren, the stories are perfect for TV and movies. They have pretty big parts in The Demon Murder Case, although they and all other names are changed for the movie. Here they are called Guy and Charlotte Harris, and they are played by Andy Griffith and Beverly McKenzie. They don't really do a lot in this, they are there to support the family, but seems nearly underwhelmed by it all. Regardless of how many cases they had before, I would think that they would be a bit more enthusiastic and emotionally involved. Instead, they seem to just leave the family, even when some crazy supernatural stuff has taken place. They also don't seem to give them any real help, except sticking by the belief that this guy's innocent due to the demonic possession. The Warrens, I mean the Harrises, still take up a good amount of screen time, and I think that could have been used better if they put more effort into the family dynamic, so we would have cared more about them. Flaws aside, I think director William Hale and screenwriter William Kelley deserves praise for their work. Both had long experience working in television before getting this assignment, and instead of going through the motions and making a bland TV movie, they seem to put a lot of effort into making this entertaining. The demon murder case has an interesting backstory that they present in a nice way, especially considering the TV format they had to work within. If you like this kind of movies and also don't mind the low production values that comes with it, then I think it is well worth checking out. Both because it actually has some qualities to it, and also because of the curiosity factor if you find the Warren cases interesting or just want to see Kevin Bacon possessed by a demon. This was a positive surprise for me, so I'm giving the demon murder case the well-deserved score of 3 out of 5. Who else has seen this one and how did you become aware of it? Are you looking forward to the next Conjuring movie? Let me know in the comment section below. Also, if you want to hear me talk about another TV movie based on the cases of the Warrens, then check out my review for the 1991 film The Haunted. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, then make sure you subscribe, as there will be plenty more videos in the future on forgotten horror movies here on CinemaTerror. Thank you.